process includes inspiration plus expiration. The system of respiration mainly constitute nose, nasal chamber, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchus, bronchioles, alveolar, lungs, right lung, left lung and diaphragm. Actually, the process of respiration and circulation continues simultaneously, continuous process which takes simultaneously. The process of respiration as well as circulation. In between two lungs, there is the presence of heart. Lungs are highly elastic, spongy structures which gives protection to the heart as well as helps in the functioning of the heart. Here, respiratory system and circulatory system present in the thoracic cage which gives the protection. Thoracic cage consists of 12 ribs which gives protection to the most important organs like lungs, heart and liver. Respiratory system of man mainly consists external or upper respiratory system having external larynx, nose having external larynx, that means openings, two openings present at the tips through which air enters. Then there is the presence of nasal passage or nasal cavity. Nasal passage divided by two chambers, divided into two chambers by cartilage, termed as mesenchymal cartilage. Then next, air from the nose and food from the mouth enters into a common passage that is called as pharynx. Pharynx is a common passage for air as well as food. Food from mouth and air from the nose. Then that pharynx continue into a sound box that is called as larynx. Larynx consists of cords, muscle flaps. When air passes through this larynx, it produces different types of sound. Therefore, it is called as sound box or yes, voice box. Larynx is also called as sound box or voice box. Then there is the presence of a long, narrow tube that is called as trachea, which is supported by half C-shaped cartilaginous rings, which prevent the collapse of this trachea. Trachea is a narrow muscular tube, but it is supported externally or in front by the C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Due to these rings, cartilaginous rings, trachea gets supported and prevents the collapse of trachea. That trachea divides into two bronchi when they enter into the thoracic cavity and divided into two bronchi and single bronchus enters into a lung. Two lungs present in the thoracic cavity, right lung and left lung. Right lung is slightly larger than left lung. Right lung consists of three lobes, left lung consists of two lobes. Each bronchioles and bronchi does not consist cartilage. These are smooth, narrow muscular tubes and single-celled thing, ends into air sacs called as alveoli. Alveoli are highly elastic bags. Each lung consists near about 700 million alveoli. How many alveoli are there? 700 million. When air enters into this alveoli, these alveoli get relaxed or expand, and when air is forced out in the expiration, that alveoli get contracted. Alveoli, each alveoli get surrounded by or richly supplied with capillaries, arteries or arterioles, venules coming together forming a veins. Arterioles, that means branching of the artery. Many arterioles surround this alveoli, and deoxygenated blood consists CO2. That CO2 enters into the alveoli, while O2 from this nose, trachea, bronchus enters into alveoli, and that O2 enters into the blood capillary. That means exchange of O2 and CO2 takes place through the wall of alveoli and blood capillary. That O2 enters into the blood capillary and supplied to the each and every cell of the body. While CO2 from each and every cell of the body, yes, coming towards the lungs and alveoli and finally pushed outside or expired outside. Exchange of O2 and CO2 is the main function of alveolus and lungs. That oxygen enters into the cell and in the cellular respiration, breakdown or complete oxidation of food
results in release of energy in the form of ATP. For energy production, oxygen is used into the cell, and that oxygen taken by this respiratory system by the mechanism inspiration and expiration, exchange of O2 and CO2. Upper respiratory system and lower respiratory system. Respiratory system of man mainly divided into two parts, upper and lower respiratory system. Upper respiratory system, that is external nares, nasal cavities, internal nares, nasopharynx and nose and throat. That means up to here, upper respiratory system is there. Nose consists pair of openings, that is called as external nares or nostrils, for entry of air into the nasal cavity. Nasal cavity divisible into right and left nasal cavity or chambers by which cartilage? Mesenchymoid cartilage. Each chamber is divided into three regions, that is vestibule, that means external chamber of nose, vestibule, then next, which consists here for filtration of air and trapping the dust particles. The next, that is the respiratory part, air conditioner, because it is used for warming up the air and in moistening the air. And third, that is the next part of nasal chamber. Third part, that is called a sensory area or sensory chamber for detection of smell. Three functions of the nasal chamber. First function, it consists ciliated epithelium, filtration of air. Second, air conditioner. Air conditioning, that means air is slightly moistened as well as warmed. Tell me the body temperature, normal body temperature 37 degree. When in the cold temperature, air consists, yes, lower temperature. That's why that air is warmed here. And then, that is, therefore, this chamber is called as air conditioner. And next, that is the, yes, for smell. Next chamber, last chamber, that is the, yes, it is for sensory chamber for the sense of smell. The next, pharynx. Pharynx is the common passage of air and food. It consists of nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. Common passage for air and food. And then larynx is the sound box or voice box. Larynx consists of cords, vocal cords for producing a sound. And that sound is produced by the passage of air between vocal cords and modulations by the teeth, tongue and vibrations, modulations of the teeth, tongue and nasal passage. And opening of this larynx into the trachea is guarded by a flap that is called as epiglottis. Here, crossing of air chamber and food chamber. Opening of food chamber, that is the esophagus, and opening of the trachea is guarded by a flap that is called as epiglottis. What is the function of epiglottis? Epiglottis prevents the entry of food into the air passage. When there is entry of food particle into the air passage, what happens? Internally, this trachea lined by ciliated epithelium and mucous membrane. When there is a particle, then there is a coughing takes place, and that particle is removed because it prevents the entry of food particle into the lungs, which is harmful. Therefore, there is a prevention and guarding by the a flap called as epiglottis. Epiglottis acts as a guard. When there is an entry of food, that flap, yes, covers the trachea. When there is an entry of air, that flap covers the trachea. The movement of that epiglottis takes place like a, yes, opening and closing of the two openings, that is the tracheal opening and esophageal opening. That epiglottis is the protective function. The next, trachea. Trachea 10 to 12 cm in length. It is supported by cartilaginous rings, which prevents the collapse of trachea. Internally, trachea is lined by ciliated epithelium and mucus glands, which traps the unwanted particles. The next, bronchus. Bronchus without cartilage enters into each lung, then divided into bronchioles. Bronchiole ends into a air sacs called as alveoli. Alveoli are highly elastic bags. In each lung, 700 alveoli are near about 700 million alveoli are present. That means it looks like a bunch of grapes, and that alveoli acts for or helps in the exchange of O2 and CO2. Overall, in the the right lung 3 lobes are there with many alveoli, and left lung consists 2 lobes. Below these lungs, the abdominal cavity and thoracic cavity is separated by a connective tissue flap, that is the diaphragm. Diaphragm helps when contraction of diaphragm, the diaphragm becomes flat and lungs get expanded. Thoracic cage consists ribs, covered by ribs. When intercostal muscles in the ribs get contracted and the thoracic cage gets expanded, as well as when the diaphragm becomes flat, thoracic cage gets expanded, lungs also expand, air pressure inside the lungs get decreased, so that the air from atmospheric air from outside rushed into the lungs. While opposite mechanism, at the time of expiration, what happens? That diaphragm becomes dome-shaped, intercostal muscles also get relaxed. At that time, lungs get contracted and air pressure inside the lungs get increased than atmospheric air pressure, and air from the lungs is expired outside. That is the mechanism. But actually, the system of respiratory system of human being is the most important system, because exchange of O2 and CO2 takes place through the alveoli and blood vessels or capillary, and that O2 is carried towards the cell for the production of energy by combustion or oxidation of the food with the help of O2. Therefore, human respiratory system mainly consists upper respiratory system, lower respiratory system,